everyone, welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to our playthrough of Fire Emblem Sacred Stones. We're gonna keep it going here with Chapter 3. First, we're just going to manage things here. Let's keep it going here. Erica and company pursue the thief who stole her bracelet. The chase leads them into the mountains, where Basba's bandits pillage Jetwell. Erica cannot ignore her countrymen's pleas for help. She leaves her group in search of the bandits' stronghold. Sets up Chapter 3, The Bandits of Borgo. The local villagers tell me that Basba's bandits keep their lair nearby. A few of them saw a lad matching the description of our bracelet thief. It seems a fair guess that the youth is one of these bandits. Bandits, here in Renee, our homeland. I had no idea. Burning our villages, stealing from our people with no fear of reprisal. Wasn't always like this. The knights used to protect the citizenry. However, with Renee in ruins and her army tattered, law and order are hard to find. It doesn't look like the Grotto army is interested in maintaining order here. If nothing changes, Renee will continue this sad plunge into savagery. Hello? Pardon me for asking, but are you all some sort of mercenary troop? Why do you ask? Please, you have to help Colm. You have to. I told him it was too dangerous, but he wouldn't listen to me. Please, you must calm yourself. Start at the beginning and speak slowly. Alright. I'm Naimi. I used to be from a village named Mark. Except the village is gone. Gone? What do you mean? Basba's bandits burned it down. Only Colm and I escaped. The other villagers, the bandits attacked them and... Naimi, what are you doing here? Basba's bandits. They have a hideout here in these mountains. That's where Colm... We've known each other since we were kids. He went to steal back something the bandits took from me. He went alone? That's a very dangerous thing. Yes, I know. That's what I told him. But he wouldn't listen to me. If I lose Colm, too, I don't know... I'll... Wait, please don't cry. Don't worry, we'll find your friend and see that he's not harmed. Really? Really and truly? Oh, thank you, thank you. I don't have much money, but I'll do anything to help. Your Highness, what will it be? If the thief we're after has gone to the bandit's lair as well, well, it seems as though we share a common cause with Naimi. She is a citizen of Renee, after all. And isn't it our duty to defend our countrymen? I'm only sad that we weren't here to protect her friends and neighbors. So yes, I feel we must help her. Very well. Naimi, I trust you can lead the way? Yes, it's this way. Is there anything I can do to help? I feel so... When I was little, I used to go hunting with my grandfather.
What I mean is I'm not bad with a bow.
Really?
Uh-huh.
I see. You should remain behind and protect Princess Erica. Not sure who's out there, but it looks like we've got guests. Let's give them a warm welcome, lads. You see a stranger? Stick an axe in them.
a little soggy. Excuse me. These bandits are easy picking. I guess I might as well start with these chests here. Press the lock. Amy's gonna go up there. Talk to him. Come on. Amy, what are you doing here? I told you to wait for me, didn't I? I couldn't. It's too dangerous. Come on, let's go home. You don't have a home. Don't you get it? Look, just leave everything to me. I can take care of it in a flash, but I don't need a clumsy oaf like you taking along. Oh, this is ridiculous. We'll talk later. Don't leave my side, Amy. Alright. Ross is killed. Are you kidding me, Ross? This is just going downhill real quickly. Oh, hi, Clum. How are you doing? This is no time for pleasantry. You need to concentrate in battle. I was just being polite. I never thought I'd see you on the battlefield. Well, I might not be the best, but when something needs to be done, I do it. It's amazing how war affects people. I mean, look at you. You're a bumbling crybaby, but even you've pulled yourself together temporarily. When we were little, you followed me everywhere, tripping and crying. Oh, why are you always so mean? And now look at you. You're still following me everywhere, tripping and crying. But now you're doing it on the battlefield. Will you please stop your boo-hooing? Okay, I'll try. Man, you can't do anything without me, can you? And stop crying. But what is it? You're the one who's making me cry. Ugh. Oh, a dick there. Something. he won't get the kill. Which is good. Should have done Iron Lance. What was I thinking? This is just not going well, is it? Not as well as it could be, anyway. There it goes. Kidding me, Ross. It's the second time now you've done this. Myself here. On some healing. So, maybe you two, Ross, maybe two, that's four, 12. I can do it this turn. I'm the head mighty bandit pack. I'm the head of this bandit pack, the mighty Bazbull. Hope you've enjoyed your life because it's about to end.
we're getting... I'm the mighty Baspa. This ain't. I'm giving her some more experience if we don't have this. One away from level up. Now, I told you not to worry. I could have robbed these bandits blind on my own, thank you very much. I was worried. Hold on, I'm sorry. Come on, don't start bawling. No more dangerous stuff by yourself. Fine, fine, I promise. But you have to stop crying all the time, alright? Oh yeah, take a look at this. I got your mirror back. Remember how you cried when we left Lark, you thought you'd lost this? I knew it was your mother's, and I knew those thugs had taken it. So I went and got it back. See what happens when you give me a job? Guaranteed results. Calm. Calm. Hey, why are you crying this time? Come on, stop. Knock it off. Please, Naomi. This is quite touching, but I think you'd best return Princess Erica's bracelet to her now. What are you talking about? Are you trying to say that I... Whoa there, hold it. It's right here. Take it. Tell me, boy. Is this the path you've chosen for your life? This girl matters to you. You must quit this dark road. Yeah. Right. We're leaving. Do not expect to be rescued again. Farewell. Hey, wait. Let's go with you. You can't just leave us here. Pardon? Amy and I, we've got no home to return to. No matter where we go, there's just going to be more fighting. You're mercenaries, right? Well, then take us with you. I'm a handy guy to have around. I know I can help you out. I prefer not, but I'll agree with Erica's decision. Our duty is a grave one, however, with no time to waste shepherding you. It's fine with us. You just wait. I promise you won't regret the decision. I retrieved your bracelet from the bandit's stronghold. Here you are, princess. Thank you, Seth. You know, father gave me this bracelet when I was a child. It has only one match in the world, and my brother wears it. Lady Erica, you must take care never to lose that bracelet. It is the proof that King Fado entrusted the future of Renee to you, his children. Seth, what is it you're not telling me? I apologize, Your Highness. When the time comes, I will tell you what I know. Until then, I see. If you tell me it must wait, then it can wait. I trust you. Then we should get moving again. We're safe from bandits for now, but I can't guarantee for how long. This is just the beginning, isn't it? If we hope to free our homeland, it will take battle after battle. I'm afraid so, Your Highness. The day you and Prince Ephraim win back the freedom and honor of Renee will come. But I fear it lies at the end of a long and treacherous road. I know. I must fight for that day. In the names of all those I could not save, I'll lead us home. Let's go. My brother awaits. At Grotto Keep. General Dussel. Selena, have you been back long? Tell me, how fares the campaign in Renee? Signs of chaos abound. Brigands ride without fear, and the peasants' cries fill the air. If Grotto's troops do not enforce public order, the situation will only worsen. And still, His Majesty has given us no orders. Perhaps just this once I should take the lead. What could His Majesty be thinking? Breaking our long-held alliance with Renee? Invading without warning? He has never been this way before. He abhors violence. And have you noticed the recent promotions? Who are they going to? Certainly not the soldiers who have Grotto's best interests at heart. I fear this invasion is the prelude to a much larger war. I feel as though His Majesty is no longer the man we knew him to be. Glenn, it doesn't matter what any of us might think of our orders. We are his servants, and we will not question his majesty's intentions. I know that, Selina. And yet... That's enough, both of you. His majesty summons us. Let us hope we can learn a little during our audience. I appreciate your work in fulfilling your previous orders. You are the hammers that drive the nails of the Empire's will. You will continue to operate, without hesitation, wherever I send you. By your command. In your majesty's name. Yes, sire. However, I know this. You, my Imperial III, lack the strength to conquer the remaining nations alone. In the invasion of Renee, certain soldiers performed beyond expectation. I've chosen them to join you as new generals in the Empire's service. Come. The performance of these men surpassed even your own. With the addition of these three, the Empire will have six generals strong enough to conquer this land. Do you understand? I'm Reeve, given the name Bloody Blood Barrel by His Majesty. I know I'm a newcomer, but I pray for your favor. Understood. I'm Kalek. I was a mercenary fighting in the desert. Seems I'm to be called Tiger Eye. You're fine looking lass, aren't you? Yeah, I'm gonna love working with you. So we meet again. You know me as General Walter, but you will call me the Moonstone. I'll save you worthless dogs from your own incompetence. You'll thank me later. Walter, you scum. Peace, Glenn. Selina, Kayla, you will bring me Frelia. Yes, sire. Sure, good as done. Reeve, Dussel, you are charged with the defense of the Empire. I will speak to you individually with more details later. Understood, Your Majesty. By your command, sire. And me? Walter, Glenn, I have other duties for you. Yes, Your Majesty. Renee has fallen, but Princess Erica still eludes us. Her brother, Prince Ephraim, leads a resistance with the Narco orders. Bring the siblings to me. Of course. Okay. And that does it for chapter 3. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time.